Zombies! And welcome back to Europe, where you're back on the road for us. As we were saying earlier, I think it's three years. 89 was the last time you were over here playing live. Have you actually been playing live since then, or was that the last time you played?
No, not at all. We did our first concert, secret gig, a couple nights ago in Windsor.
Right, in England.
Yeah, typical disaster.
It must be quite unnerving, I suppose, to go back on stage and doing it. I'm sure it's not like riding a bike where they say you never forget. It's like, whoop, here we go.
Well, you just have to try and remember, try and relearn how to not overact.
Right, yeah, because it's not a natural environment at all, is it?
Yeah.
I mean, do you like possibly playing live? Is that something which you enjoy yourself personally? Or?
I prefer the control and the studio itself.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's good. Just depends. Yeah. I mean, Edinburgh and Amsterdam are my two favourite places.
So tonight should be good. Right, well, we're going to catch you in a while, some of Swans Live here in Edinburgh. Right now we have video, and this is your interpretation of an old Joy Division song.
Oh
yes. La Frontera's apart.
signs that lets you right or wrong.
That was some of the Swans live here in Edinburgh. You'll be seeing some more of that in a moment, or a different song probably. I was actually reading about you as a lyricist, I think about 2 weeks ago. Hey, everybody thinks, what have I said now? you were saying that you describe your approach now as you'd rather be seen as a narrator of yourself rather than a person.
Oh, I don't want to be seen at all, but
But your approach to it rather than the person, so to say, a person in pain kind of thing, more as the person who's observing.
Yeah, I just try and get out of the way.
Yeah. Is that for your own health, mentally or physically? Or
just for everyone's benefit.
Yeah. But with the new album, you did 3 months you spent just recording it? It was like in Wham Bam and...
Yeah, I went, it was in Brooklyn. We had a mattress and we just stayed there and worked 3 months.
Intense recording.
Were you writing
in the studio as you went, or did you have the songs before you?
No, we write everything before we go in. But I mean, things happen, of course, in the studio.
Yeah.
But I don't have the money to go in and just fool around, so
sure.
I don't do that, and I think it would be kind of immoral anyway to waste money in the studio.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, well, we're going to go back and see some more of you live on stage right now.
and you're an angel. I'll never betray you, but I'll always be a lonely child.
Actually, earlier on in the show, I was talking to a group called Ride, and we were working our way through their videos, and they came up with the same comment that you've just come up with, which was, you know...
complete embarrassment.
Yeah. But the same thing about not actually having control over it is a frustrating thing anyway.
Yeah. Well, that won't ever happen again.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the recent video for Love of Life,
we
just made ourselves entirely. Start to finish, so I feel good about that.
Yeah.
And we made one for a song called A Screw, which is, I really like that a lot too.
Right.
But the other ones I feel pretty ambivalent about.
Yeah. You think it's because they're, I mean, for a lot of, obviously for musicians, it's their main concentration is their music. But also there's a tendency to be blinded with the science of it when it comes to videos. You know, you have these people come in saying, oh no, you can possibly do it, you can't have a good idea.
Well, it's just like with major labels, you know, they always want to kind of get their fingers on your brain and squeeze out whatever they can.
Yeah.
So they want to just control you as much as they can. And they just make the whole thing seem like you're just this little artist and they pat you on the head and they do the same thing with videos, you know, like,
yeah.
Oh, we know best, don't worry. You know.
Yeah, we've done it before.
Yeah, we've done it before. It's like, oh, you've got to have this producer, don't worry, you know, he'll take care of you.
Yeah. Which, the same old routine.
Yeah.
Okay, well listen, we've got a bit more live performance now, and then we've got another old video coming up after the record. Twice.
I will be ready to rest. in your soul will damn you to hell. The sex in your soul will damn you to hell. Damn you to hell.
Damn you to hell.
I will be there. When it calls my number, I will be there. Let the light come in. Damn you to hell. Let the light come in. Damn you to hell. Slaves like us, designed to fetishize consumption, waste, and an identity based on a dying lie. So God forgive America, the end of history is now, and God may save the victim, but only the murderer holds real power.
We're about to actually leave here now, as it were, but you had a few words you wanted to say, Chris.
I would like to say, China out of Tibet.
Okay, we get the message. And you're heading around Europe for the next month, actually, into April, anyway.
Yeah, we're slogging around, getting beat up by people.
Well, enjoy it, and I recommend if you have any opportunities to go see the Swans, do so. And they're going to come up live now. But before I go, next week, 120 minutes, we're in Brussels. That's in Belgium, where I'm sure you knew. And on the show, we have La Muerte, we have Front 242, also The Young Gods, as well as new videos and a bit of chit-chat, as we usually do. So I'll see you then. I'll leave you now with the Swans. 9 o'clock next week for 120 minutes. Bye-bye.